So when you will hold the phone first time in your hands, it actually feels very lightweight and very slim. And in 2018, when most of the phones are coming either with a full metal back or with a full glass back, which are way too slippery and completely impossible to use without a case, the Pixel 2 XL on the other hand comes with this matte black finish at the back, so you can easily use this phone without a case. But for the people, those who are looking forward to buy a white variant should definitely get a case, because a lot of people have reported that the white polish gets chipped off from certain areas. Now when you had set up the phone and everything and you begin to look at its display, you will notice that there is a sort of a color shift as you tilt the display at certain angles, and this is not just the problem with my phone but other Pixel devices as well. So you should be completely aware of this fact before buying this one. If you will have a look around at its bezel, you will notice that the left side of the phone has a nano SIM card tray. I wished it had a dual SIM, because now my other SIM is lying around on the table. Then on the right, you have been given the home, the power button on the top, and below that you have been given the volume buttons, which are very soft and tactile. The top of the phone carries a noise cancellation mic, and at the bottom you get a Type-C charging port. The phone does not have any kind of expandable storage or a 3.5mm jack, so this is kind of a downside, at least for me. The Pixel 2 XL also carries this single camera, which is not protruding too much out of the surface, so you can easily use the phone while keeping it on the table. Now talking about the software, if you'll go into the app drawer, you will notice that you have been given a Google search bar on the top, which you can use to search anything on the web and also the applications that are there in the phone. Then the first line in the app drawer shows your most recent applications, and then below that it shows you the most recent contacts or the most used contacts. Now I don't really like the idea of showing contacts in the app drawer. And then three new applications I came across in the Android Pie, which are the Google Allo app and the Google Notes app, which is kind of a much needed application for me. And then you have the Daydream application. While I used the phone, I felt that the Google has paid attention to very small little things in the software. Like for example, the notification panel is by default white in color, and also the app drawer is white in color. But if you are actually using any wallpaper that has a dark accent, then the notification panel changes to dark gray, and also the app drawer changes to dark gray. So it is kind of like the phone is able to theme itself automatically depending upon what kind of wallpaper you are choosing. Apart from that, the phone, if you are using any light colored wallpaper, then the top of the phone actually displays some sort of a shadow so that your date, time, battery percentage and notifications are clearly visible. Overall, I would like to say that the Android 9.0 is very smooth and very, you don't notice any kind of lags in the phone, and also it brings a lot of functionality and lot of usual changes within the software. And this amount of, although it's not possible to show you all the settings, but whenever you will open different kind of settings, you will notice small animations coming up, which gives you a very different feeling. And I would say that the Android 9.0 really offers a lot of functionality than previous versions of Android. Now talking about the most important part of the phone, which is its camera. Now I'm not going to talk about how good the camera is, because we all know that all the Pixel phones have very impressive cameras, but still there is something that I want to talk about, the overall UI of the camera. Now first of all, this UI does not offer you a lot of functionality. Like for example, I wish the camera had a manual mode. Although a lot of people don't use manual mode, the majority of people actually just want to take the phone out of their pockets and just want to snap a photo. But for tech enthusiasts like me and for some of you, we wish that the phone should have a manual controls so that we are able to explore the camera to a much greater extent. Now the camera application in the Pixel 3 has completely reformed, and it brings a lot more functionality, and I'm just waiting for that update to receive in my phone. And meanwhile, here are some sample shots that I was able to take with the phone and some video footage.
Although it's a Google phone, you may think that it's a complete phone, but actually this phone has a lot of issues related to the hardware as well as the software. Like for example, if I talk about these buttons, especially the power button and the volume button, they actually make a lot of noise. I don't know if you can hear that. Okay, I hope you are able to hear the sound. So these buttons actually make a lot of noise, and I was able to notice that when I was using the phone at night, and this is a very bit annoying. Although it's a hardware issue and nothing can be done about that, but Google should really take care of these kind of problems. The second problem is related to the software. Now, taking away the headphone jack, I don't know if it was a good move from Google, but let me show you that it has some issues. Like for example, this is the Google Play Music application, and suppose if I'm playing any song from this, let's say, okay, this one. Let me just raise up the volume a bit. So till now everything works fine, but as soon as I plug in the earphone jack, there is actually 2 seconds lag for the audio to actually transfer from the loudspeaker to the earphone. Let me show you that. Did you get that? It was not actually 2 seconds, it was more than 2 seconds. It's kind of 3 seconds lag for the audio to actually transfer through this dongle, which was initially supplied with the box. And these are the JBL earphones which I'm using. I'll show you that once again. So this is another software issue, and it's not just these two problems, but there are like tons of software issues in the entire phone. It would be very difficult for me to compile that in a single video, but these are some of the major ones that I came across, so I'm telling you that. Apart from that, if you're buying this phone in India in 2018, then you will be coming across two major more problems. Like first, the problem is related to the Wi-Fi connectivity. Now, I'm at home and I'm using the Airtel broadband, and you can see that right now the signal strength is completely full, but as I move couple of meters away from my Wi-Fi, the Wi-Fi connection actually drops, and you will notice a drops also in the signal strength. And this is actually the second unit that I got replaced from Paytm. The first one had the issue like that, so I was not able to diagnose that. So I got that phone replaced, and this is actually the second phone, and this also has same kind of problem. Now actually I searched the web for different kind of articles out there. So what I did was that I refreshed my Wi-Fi settings and the network settings, and now it's like better than before, but still it's not the best one. Then the second problem that you will come across with the Pixel 2 XL, it's the battery. Now a lot of people have reported that the battery gets heated up while charging, and that is definitely an issue with the phone. Although that was the problem with my first unit, but the second unit that I got it replaced, there's no problem related to the battery. And on paper, the 3420 mAh of battery may seem very much sufficient, but even with a moderate use, you can actually kill this phone in half a day. So what I did was that I went into the developer options and I reduced my animation scale from 1x to 0.5x. And if you are using the phone in the battery saving mode, it actually helps a lot. So you can now, if I am leaving the home with 100% battery and coming back after 12 hours, you will still have 40% of the juice remaining in the phone. So friends, these was some of the problems and issues with the Pixel 2 XL. And if you ask me about if you should get this phone in 2018, now first of all, you should take care of some facts, like the phone does not have expandable storage, it's not a dual SIM phone, it does not have a 3.5 millimeter jack, and the implementation of this jack, it's actually some kind of hardware or a software issue, as you can see that the audio was lagging through the earphones. So these are the problems that you should take care of before buying this one. And my primary reason of buying this phone was that I've never used a Pixel device before. I wanted to see how a phone with the original Google software feels in your hand. So that was the reason for buying this one. And the second reason was I was getting a very good exchange on my 2-year-old Moto Z Play. Selling this phone in 15,000 rupees was a very impressive deal. So these are like some of the reasons and if you ask me, I would clearly say that you should get this phone at least once and have a look of what Google is offering. And also the Google Assistant and some of the software features are actually different from the stock Android that you get on the OnePlus or the other Moto phones. So friend, this was all about the video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to give a like and subscribe to the channel. And I'll be posting some more videos on the Pixel 2 XL. Thank you so much for watching.